And this concept here of taking an input and transforming it in polynomial time into a new input for another problem so that you get the same solution is known as a polynomial time reduction. And if you want to be precise about what you're applying this reduction to, you can say that you have a polynomial time reduction from x to y. So in other words, you can take a problem x and show that the problem y is powerful enough to solve problem x. So in order to help you wrap your head a little bit more around polynomial time reductions, we'll do a little quiz here. So I would like you to think about, if we manage to reduce a problem x to another problem y, what does that imply? And I'm going to give you four choices here, and I know it's easy to guess which one of those are correct, but you should really give this some thought first to make sure that you understand the concept of reductions, because this is going to play a very important role in this unit and also in the next units. So I'll give you four choices here. Does reducing a problem x to a problem y imply that x is at least as hard to solve as y? And by hardness, I mean the distinction between polynomial time and exponential time. So in this case here, for example, if y is only solvable in exponential time, does that mean that x can only be solved in exponential time as well? Or is it the other way around? Does it imply that y is at least as hard to solve as x? Does it mean that if x can be solved in polynomial time, then so can y? Or does it mean that if y can be solved in polynomial time, then so can x? So please check all of the answers here that are correct.